This is how I live. I live. This is what I love. This is all the things that my dreams have been made of.
Welcome to my life. This is what I love. This is what the soundtrack to my life is made of. Music, love, life.
Christal Jordan, Be Honest, and myself, Kevin Davis, we are Music, Love, Life. Welcome to another episode.
Where is our music?
It's there.
But we don't hear it.
Why do you need to hear this? Be professional.
I like to hear it.
Be a professional. You know what I'm saying?
It gets me in the mood.
That's not how it is in Hollywood.
It does.
Hollywood is not that way.
Do you think they do that on The Price is Right or something? They have
actually, you do hear that when you're in the audience.
It's a live audience.
It's a live audience.
But you think it on pornos, they should... Do you think the music's playing in the porno?
On porno?
Yeah, you think
I don't know.
There's no live music in porno.
I hope they're not fucking the waka-do, waka-do,
they're
waka-do,
not.
Waka-do,
they're not.
I don't think that's the same music that plays in the contemporary porno.
Do you think that they get their original heart on there? No, it's a fluffer. There's somebody,
it is a fluff
there's
girl.
Somebody backstage, male or female, that's getting their dick hard.
I would hope it would. Well, okay. Well, it's a,
you never know. It's a
lot
free
of, state, free country.
I didn't know you knew so much about behind the scenes.
I have a cousin.
You
that,
ever did an entrepreneurial what? Effort? Yeah.
Have a cousin?
I had a cousin that was attempting to do some local porn here.
Does that mean a dude with a video camera in his bedroom?
I don't know. So he didn't follow through because it was just weird. But the ad was in Creative Loafing, and you know,
oh my god,
he tried it. It was like, it just wasn't. The guys in porn is just, it's not worth it. Unless
what
you're
do you
like
mean a, it's not worth it.
The money isn't right. The attitude about them is different. They're not treated well. They're
what
like
is the
they're
attitude?
Props. They're props.
Oh. Okay.
The girls matter, the guys don't.
That's a welcome change.
So wait, he responded to a Craigslist ad or something, showed up at the hotel and expect to be treated like a star?
Like an actor.
Right.
Well, I mean, this is before Craigslist, so this is like Creative Loafing. You know what that is? Like,
we know, the magazine here in Atlanta.
Yeah, well, it's that. So
it's a newspaper.
I mean, it was a beginning effort. It wasn't like a production, so...
No, it was a production. I mean, from what it said in the ad.
But it's local. Nobody does real production porn
in
Atlanta.
Well, because it's illegal.
Is it? I don't think it is.
Yeah, you can't be there's no only, prima donna. Like, the fuck are you doing?
There's only one place where porn is legal.
In L.A.?
California. There's,
oh, okay.
there's a county.
Oh.
You have to, that's where all
so
those,
all the porn comes from that one county?
The legal porn does.
I did not know that.
Yeah.
Oh. Is all... Well... Okay.
Well, people upload their own. Can't
well,
you do that
now? Well, that's
different,
though. You can't make people not upload their own. You know,
but you penis. Can you can charge for your own shows.
Jasmine, what's her name? She did.
You know what?
She did though.
Did she really do that?
She has a channel. Her and her ex, the guy who was vouching for her,
ex husband.
They had a channel where they often did rape type. Rough sex scenes. I'm just saying, you can't write this shit.
Wow. Wow. I mean, there's that and what? Half of Instagram?
What do you mean?
Have like private Snapchat?
Yeah, they have. There are private, like you can make your Instagram, you can monetize your Instagram so that you can, you know, have a private Snapchat. Because really, before, girls were just free, naked for free. Which
before?
No one should ever be. On Instagram, the girls were just naked for free. Now, you can show a little bit and then say, hey, subscribe to my private Snapchat, which is paid, and then people can see everything. It's like a peep show.
Nobody should be naked for free.
No, I'm against that. I've always spoken against it.
You said before, like it was a thing of the past.
I meant,
like I can't pull somebody's titties
up right now. Early in social
media
years, people were naked for free.
I do remember a side boob, or was it under boob?
Both.
Should that be monetized at all, or is
my
that
under boob?
Someone's. They look
well,
like
those
you.
Are the teases. They'll show you the side boob or the under boob and say, swipe up.
So yeah, that's what it is.
Full
swipe
nipple
up.
Okay, charge.
First of all, I don't know. What happened is there was an artistic picture that I posted that had a hint of cleavage, not. Anything that
was a cleavage between the bottom of your boob and your stomach,
my chest.
Chest, sorry,
under boob.
But it wasn't a full on under boob, and it was definitely not swipe up worthy.
Okay, did you get a lot of comments?
I did, okay. But it's only because
were they
I'm
about the boob or the art?
It was about the art.
Yeah, right.
I'm extremely conservative, though, so people give me a lot of comments like whenever I do anything.
Yeah, like that art.
Kind of like Trump conservative?
Well, no, not at all. But okay. I think that's ridiculous. And whenever I do anything, guys are like, take that down. What are you doing? And I'm like, what? I'm not doing anything.
What? I'm not doing anything. I just can't help it. Right. I get so much attention when I do stuff.
That's not true.
I didn't know.
What? You guys like this stuff?
Oh, you guys are gross.
Oh my God. Whatever. That actually reminds me of a conversation I've had. I'm going to ask, we talked about this before. A couple of my guy friends have been telling me that one of my friends and I were in a conversation. He was saying that women are illogical and irrational and make no sense. He was like, crazy. Like, and I was like, no, men are crazy too. If women are crazy, then men are crazy too. And he was like, no, no. He said, I can explain anything a man does in 30 seconds. And you cannot explain anything that a lot of these females are doing. I was like, yes, I can. Try me. So he tells me that a girl calls him and tells him that she, you know, they're talking. Now, she has a fiance. And then she tells him that she wants him to take pictures of her in a bikini for a bikini contest. A video. At a hotel. Just the two of them. And he's like, what? And then she's like, yeah. And then he's like, okay, well, he tries to like make a move. He's like, well, you should come by. And she's like, no, I don't want to come by your house. Like, she acts like that's crazy. And then another guy said, oh, yes, these type of things do happen. A girl will come in my house and then I'll say, well, you know what? I'm going to go home. It's late. She's like, no, you can stay. Please stay. He stays on the sofa. Then she says, you know what? I can't hear you out there on the sofa. Come in the bedroom. He comes in the bedroom. She has on a G-string and a bra. She tells him to lay down, turns over and toots up her behind, but will not allow, but then gets mad if he touches her. Then another guy had the same situation and said the girl got mad because he didn't touch her. So
that's accurate.
Yeah, you guys.
Is that normal?
Yeah, you guys are. Yeah, those egomaniacs.
Those experiences, I'm afraid, are more common than you'd like to think.
That does sound a little crazy. That
you
sounds just a bit crazy.
Your ego.
That's
stroke.
The standard.
That is what. What is that though? What do you guys think is happening in that situation? What's happening?
Enough guys didn't compliment you that day, so only maybe 50 guys complimented you. You need that 55.
I do think that is the girl want. The girl wants him to like her, but she doesn't want to like him.
It's the no, stop, but that doesn't actually mean stop.
No, it means stop.
No, it doesn't mean stop.
It does mean stop. She doesn't want to have sex. She just wants you to want to have sex.
I don't see any universe where that works. No.
It does work because in none of these situations did anyone have sex.
They should have. If she wants you to want to have sex, she wants to have
sex. That's not true.
She just doesn't want to initiate.
No, that's not true. I'm sitting here telling you. That's not true. Sometimes you just want to know, like you guys said, you just want to know that he's desirable to.
Are you speaking this from experience?
I haven't done that. I think that's ridiculous and foolish. No. In fact, I'm like, because I'm not going to, I'm not going to do that. Because I'm not doing that, I would rather just not go to the guy's house at night because I know I don't have sex. But I've been told that's stupid. Guys are like, oh, that's stupid. You should just come.
And have sex. You should just come and have sex.
No.
I mean, that's what we're here for. Whenever you get ready, you can go and mute that.
But that's like saying I want to have sex, but I don't want to come.
No, it isn't.
Smoke, don't inhale.
Right.
It's just saying I would like to play around.
Touch, don't taste.
With the idea.
Taste, don't
play
enjoy.
Play around with what idea?
Taste, don't enjoy. That's funny.
You want to play around the idea that we are sexual, but you don't want to actually have sex?
I just want to feel desirable. I'm assuming... I would love to have a young lady chime in because I haven't done that. But I just think in a girl's head, that's what that means.
You
want to
do it. You just don't want to be responsible for it.
You don't want another body.
I'm telling you, the girls don't want to have sex. Like, the guy leaves and they don't have sex.
Why would a woman not want to have sex? What about a woman's makeup makes her not? Everything in your body is firing.
That particular girl has a whole fiance.
I missed that part. So she got in bed with somebody butt naked.
She wanted him to come over and tape her in a bikini at a hotel.
Where was
her fiance couldn't do that?
He's out of the country.
Okay, so a girlfriend couldn't do that?
I would ask a girlfriend to do that.
That couldn't have been a same-sex photo shoot?
On the way to Home Depot, there's many Mexicans out there. One of them could have did it.
Why do you continue to do this to our Mexican
day workers?
Brothers and sisters?
What's wrong with that? They're there. It's not. It's a fact. Am I lying? Haven't you been on the road to Home Depot?
Why do you continue to do this?
You turn off the main street.
I've been to more than one location to Home Depot.
Have you ever got a Mexican to help you with something? It's a few dollars.
Why do you insist upon doing this?
That's not a disrespectful thing.
It's not, but you know what? It's not a lot of Mexicans out there because now they all do construction. They all ride in the same truck.
You know what? I hola.
Trump gets them out of
hola.
Here.
Hola, my friend.
The hammer's coming.
No, it's not. Nobody's paying attention to him. Well, obviously, some people are.
I thoroughly enjoy his tweets. I don't know how you guys don't find the humor in this guy.
Well, I think it's dangerous because I feel like, and I mean, this is a horrible segue, but I think that his attitude is what's causing a lot of racial tension to happen. Racial and I don't know, like just hate.
I mean, that's just one of them. Trump is irrational as some of the females that you spoke about a moment ago. Totally.
He's kind of female.
Now, that was insulting, okay?
He's got a lot of female characteristics.
He's like a female. Females are not like Trump. You guys are not making a whole lot of sense.
Sometimes I did it, but I didn't want to do it.
Wants all the attention. Come on.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't see that coming. I didn't see us going this way. Girls are not like Trump. Girls are not like Trump. That's ridiculous.
Little.
No.
Fake hair.
Oh. Mm. That one hurt.
Spray tan?
That one hurt. Mm. That one hurt.
Bundle of writing a book.
That one hurt.
A book. A damn book.
Mm. Oh, man.
And he was outsmarted by a woman recently.
Okay, what does that make him like a woman? Well, we definitely don't know men are outsmarting women.
Okay, sure.
I'm just saying, they're not.
Well, I thought the women were being more like men these days.
They are.
Trying.
Mm-hmm.
Trying.
Toxic masculinity?
Not a thing.
That is a thing.
There's nothing more toxic masculinity.
Toxicity.
You know what I'm saying? There's nothing more toxic masculinity than God.
You know what? He's just pulling our chain. He's just pulling our chain. I'm not gonna respond.
Oh yeah,
to that
was bait. That was bait.
It's true.
Bait. I wish we had like a. You know what? I'm gonna get a bait sign. And God is like, Deanna says some dumb shit.
Even though alpha males bait. Aren't real, God is like the ultimate.
Alpha males aren't real.
Not at all.
That is not true.
Toxic masculinity is God. That's God. But hey, you know, keep believing in that.
He's an angry little beige man, isn't he?
As I'm smiling, I'm angry.
He's just a bitter man.
I'm just curious where she's going to take this because she sees it. She's like, I'm not going to touch it. I'm going to leave it right there on the table.
It's just
she's
like a, touch it. It's like a wet noodle. It's just, I'm not going to touch it. I don't want anything to do with that. It's like a limp penis. No one wants that.
See, this is why guys send dick pics. This is why.
Oh, my God. Because
as much as you say, I don't like that.
I don't like it. You can't stop looking at it.
And she body shames the wet noodle guy.
Right. Like, no. This is terrible.
I don't like it. I don't like the pictures. I do not. Now, I would prefer if a guy was going to send me a picture of a nice chest and arms shot, like in a wife beater. I like that. That's attractive. That makes me, that would get my juices flowing. Not a dick pic.
Well, you got her Instagram. You know how to find her. It's right at the bottom of the screen. Send away.
I don't think there are a lot of guys that could actually take those pics because there are not a lot of guys in the gym.
Okay. Well, for those that are.
For the two guys in the gym.
We just put you on.
That is attractive. That is, I'm telling you, women would like that way more. Like, we like a nice body, you know, like, you know, shoulders, chest, you know, just...
And she's got a new vagina, by the way. It's certified used.
Mint condition.
Got less miles.
Certified. 36 point inspection.
Like a used car that has been certified.
Right. It's been through a 135 point inspection.
Oh, that's a lot more points now. I remember when it was 36 points.
I mean, this is at the top of the top. Okay. You know, this know ain't just any old used. Right,
you can get a warranty on that.
This ain't a used car of some old
you
lady.
Can
this
get
is
a
the real thing.
You can get a
can
warranty,
get a
on,
warranty
that.
On that.
Does your vagina have a warranty?
Well, I don't think so.
Oh, damn.
But if I can go back to the doctor again.
Well, I mean, it costs again, though.
You can go back and be like, hey, it's leaking.
It's supposed to leak, I think.
It's feeling old again. It's supposed to leak. Ugh, that don't sound... It shouldn't say leaking. That's not the right word. Is leaking the right word?
It was a car reference.
Leak?
I don't know.
You got a better term?
What? I don't know. Leak just sounds like a problem.
It's defected?
Well, yeah. Like if your engine is leaking, that's not good.
No, it's not.
You shouldn't just be walking around leaking.
Well, why else would you take it back?
One of the walls fell. That's something.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Vaginal mesh
came down. Can we stop talking about that? I don't want to talk about that anymore. Guys, I don't want to talk about my vagina
anymore. Okay, change the subject.
Let's just stop talking about
it. Go ahead, change the subject.
All right. So, no, I was talking about Trump and the hate, but we all know it's very serious that Jussie Smollett was attacked in a hate crime that to me is like circa 1930. Like, we haven't seen stuff like this happen. I mean, obviously there are outlying incidents that happen maybe once every few years of someone, but this is like pre-slavery. It's weird, you know, to me, for him to be in a subway, and I guess there was a
subway restaurant, right?
Subway restaurant, getting a footlong perhaps. And
is that a gay joke?
No, that was a gay joke. No, it wasn't.
Christal just slang a gay joke.
No, I didn't. I just think he's like one joke of the most amazing people in his energy is so good. Like, it's just
they must watch the show because there's no way if a dude is just sitting in unless he's like got on a tight pink jumpsuit or something,
he doesn't wear tight pink jumpsuits.
What the hell made him look gay in Subway?
No, there was
a foot long.
He had been receiving hate messages that said that someone was going to try to kill him.
Oh, so they had been calling him a black.
And using the F word. So that had happened. And then obviously someone was following him and attacked him. And now he's in the hospital. And I mean, the outpouring on Instagram is
over. That's scary.
It is. I mean, and I think that I'm going to put it like this. I don't even believe that Trump is as racist as his tweets suggest. I think that he likes to incite emotion. And
what tweet are you talking about that was racist?
Well, I mean, he says a lot of things that
he did say that there was talk about the teenager from the Catholic high school in Covington, mm-hmm, that was in being disrespectful to the elder, right? Vietnam elder.
Right.
Right. And he invited the teenager wearing the MAGA hat, mm-hmm, to the White House.
Okay.
Yeah.
And nothing towards the elder.
That's just one thing. He's said so many different things. I'm not going to go into.
I don't think you know. Thing. I think you just say like, that's just
rhetoric. It isn't. He makes
a lot of racism is throwing stones
subtle
and hiding your hand.
No, it's subtle.
I didn't do that. I'm not racist. I see fine people on both sides.
It's very difficult.
It's support of racist behavior. You know what I mean? Like he just did.
What racist behavior?
Why would you invite the student that was being hateful towards a veteran?
Why are you saying he was hateful?
The student?
Yes. Did you see the video?
Yeah.
So what part of it was hateful that was more hateful than the black Israelites over there throwing just fucking lobbing those fucking things they say out? The environment of that is very, very, very volatile anyway.
I didn't say it wasn't, but I don't know
enough about that event.
Okay.
Like, why were those groups
together
all
at the same time?
That is a good point.
When you think about it, the fact that those groups were all together, I'm not surprised that that happened.
Right.
I'm just wondering, like,
why today?
Who set that up? Like, what the hell's going on?
I think the kids were on a school field trip to New York.
Right.
The black Israelites are always out there talking about white people. And I'm not sure where the Native American came in and how the hell his drum got there, but I'm assuming that maybe somebody plays drum in Times Square every now and then.
Like, that was almost a stereotype.
But the Native American dude walked right up into the kid's face. I mean, it's a teenager. You don't walk up on teenagers like that.
I thought the teenager walked
other
into
way.
His face.
Other way. The drum guy walked up and started playing the drum right in his face. You know what I'm saying? And so
that's the closest he been to some rhythm.
I don't know. I don't know that he was being a racist kid. Wearing that hat doesn't make him a racist. I don't know that he was being a racist kid. He was probably just being a kid. And I know you're like, well, if it was a black kid, y'all would have called him a thug. But I wouldn't have. I wouldn't have called him a thug.
You're right. Wearing that hat does not make him a racist. but racists are wearing those hats.
Possibly.
Thank you.
Some of them.
So
Kanye West wore the hat. He's not a racist.
He is a racist against his own people. Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
I'm not arguing.
Okay, so what were Jussie Smollett?
There were.
This is problematic.
Yeah, it is problematic. I think.
Yeah, it's not what you're thinking.
It is.
It's very, very, very unfortunate.
Tell me your problem.
That happened to him.
I mean, I think that Trump being in office and the things that he does and says consistently, even just him wanting this, him putting all the focus of political power in the country, in our country, on this wall to keep out Mexican immigrants, is ridiculous. And I think that it's making people who are racist, because there has been a culture of racism being something that people were not welcome to say in public. But I think even as we've seen a lot more overt racism, I think, since Trump has been in office. And I think this is an example of that.
Okay.
Why do you feel that the racists are more active under the Trump presidency?
I don't feel that they are. She said that. I didn't say that. You're looking at me, but she's the one who said that. Why are you looking at me still?
No, because you act like, hey, he's not, but there are facts.
You just asked me do I think they are, and I don't think that they are.
No, because there are facts that hate crimes have increased.
What he's saying is that it's true.
Hate crimes have definitely increased.
And he's asking what you think about it.
So here's the thing, right? Well, can we talk specifically about Jussie? What's his name? Jussie
Smollett,
or Jussie?
Jussie.
All right, so here's let's talk about the facts. This is very problematic.
Mm-hmm.
First is he had just gotten off of a plane from another city.
Mm-hmm.
So you're telling me that these people sent him a death threat back in New York. And as soon as he touches down in Chicago and goes to get a Subway sandwich, they're on his ass, right?
Mm-hmm.
First problem. Second problem, they said they checked all the boxes. Black man, check. Gay, check. They said that nigger, check.
They said the F word.
The F word. Oh, they
well,
said.
Well, I think he covered the black and the gay.
No. Yeah, yeah.
Well, oh, but I'm just saying.
They brought a noose along for some reason, check. Then as they're running off, they say, MAGA, check. Come on, give me a fucking break. Is this obviously a false flag? In this case, it's a false gay flag, but it's still a false flag. This is ridiculous. There is too many coincidences here.
So what are you saying?
I'm saying this is bullshit. This is some bullshit false flag thing to make people
angry. You don't think this happened?
Angry. No, it definitely happened. And sadly, they sacrificed one of their own.
Okay, I see what you're saying.
I'm saying that the liberal, the gay, whatever the agenda was.
You think the LGBTQ community planted them there?
I think that somebody on that side, I'm not sure, saying it was the gay people, I'm not saying it was the liberals, somebody on that side made this ridiculous embellished idea of 1930s. Like that is ridiculous. That doesn't happen.
I agree.
That's not how things happen.
I know. I agree with the fact that that's over the top.
It's
like
way,
a noose.
Everything. They checked every box.
They did.
MAGA. They even said MAGA. Come on, man. Like, I know that in ISIS, they like ISIS. They do that so that you know it's them. Americans don't do that.
Dope.
The Klan, yes, they do. They always.
They do.
They do. They claim it. Ku Klux Klan put a hood on and they go out there and they burn your yard and shit. They don't, you know what I'm saying? They disappear. But these guys, like, it was all so perfect. Death threat. 2 days later. Did you see the death threat? Did you see the crayons?
Nah, I didn't see the death threat.
Give me a fucking break.
I want to see the death threat.
How ridiculous could this be? I hate the fact that I like that dude. I think he's a good actor.
And he's just a good guy. Like,
and he seems like a genuine good dude. And that's what makes it so fucking ridiculous.
He's a decent human being.
He is. And that's what makes it so ridiculous, is that they were willing to sacrifice. And the fact that they had to really beat his ass to make you guys be outraged. They couldn't just touch him up. They had to really beat his ass. You know what I'm saying?
So you mean to tell me that there's some group out there that
absolutely.
COINTELPRO against
absolutely.
Jussie Smollett.
You're calling it as if that didn't happen. You're calling like there isn't shit that makes people think one way in misdirection. You're acting like that isn't happening to be classified.
It does happen, and it is a bit, like I was like, that is a bit extreme.
A noose.
And nigger.
And
you're gay.
They doused him with bleach and
they
vanished into
with
the
bleach.
Night.
Get a skin color. We got to get that skin off of you. Boy, you beat him half near death. I block her in the June bug.
Hey, you got plans tonight? We're gonna get that boy off the TV.
Did somebody get a plane ticket? We gotta get to Chicago. That boy's in Chicago.
I don't know, but I think that It is.
It's fancy. That is a fancy ass whooping.
Skunky, get my rope and my bleach.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop.
Pull the truck around. Stop doing front. That. I mean,
guys, we're not making jokes. He's in the hospital.
No, it's sad. That's sad. I hate
He's that. Alive.
I hate that he got his ass whooped because it looks like he got his ass really whooped.
Yeah.
And I've had a fractured rib before. It's a painful thing because there's not a cast for that.
Right. You have to just gotta you gotta rest.
You gotta breathe through it. And to every breath, you feel every single breath.
Ooh.
Mm. So I hate that happened to him. However, come on, y'all. You got to look at the breadcrumbs. This is ridiculous. This is the most ridiculous one.
But I think that I think that it could be extremists on either side.
Right.
But I think the fact that Trump has incited this culture is still making it worse. I think that's what it is. I think they are. If let's just play devil's advocate and say that is okay. An extremist on that side, because I don't know. I don't feel like gay people are really, I don't think that the culture of today suggests that that's something that they get persecuted for as much. Like
for being gay?
Yeah, to me it seems to be all the rave. It's everywhere.
It's trendy.
This is trendy.
What I don't like about America right now is because every time something happens,
and I'm not saying
the conspiracy theorists, like we're all
definitely not saying it's trendy. I'm not saying that it's a trend. No, I just want to clear that up.
Gay people plan this against him.
I didn't say that.
It's counterintelligence.
As much as I don't want to believe that, it does seem I was just like, what? They did what? Like that sounds so 1930 Birth of a Nation movie-ish.
Think about all the things that happened in recent times, let's say within our teenage to adult years, that were really ridiculous. For instance, they had the guy in Jasper, Texas. They chained him to a bumper and drug him. Mm-hmm. There was
somebody else in Mississippi that ran over by a truck.
There was somebody who actually got hung from a tree in probably Mississippi or somewhere down there.
That's happened a few times.
There was the noose
hanging in Centennial Park. What was that, two years ago?
There was the noose hanging from a classroom door. Remember there? So there are isolated incidents, but this is fucking everything at once. They used every single one. He didn't say jigaboo. That's probably the only thing that wasn't done.
But I mean, he didn't say.
So what did they get? A- in hate?
No, it's an A+.
It's an A+. I'm just saying,
it's everything.
It is very, very just over the top. You know what I mean? And I think somebody was trying to prove a point and send a message because even for him, he's been like the poster boy for equality.
Y'all sound like Erykah Badu. She said, we don't have all the facts.
I can't believe before that you go she said anything. I don't understand what her agenda is because for her to come out and
say
something.
Why does everybody have to have an agenda?
Oh, no, she has an agenda. She spoke up in defense of R. Kelly. Now something happens and this young man is in the hospital fighting for his life and she speaks up in defense of whatever happened against him. Like
he's not fighting
what
for his
is
life.
She he is fighting for his life.
He's not fighting for his life.
He's they beat fighting him enough. For breaths.
They beat him.
It's not funny. No, turn his mic off.
You said breaths. That's what I'm laughing at.
I can't turn his mic off because
she said breaths. Did she say breaths?
He's fighting for breaths.
Multiple breaths.
Mm-hmm. Stop
More
it.
Than one. Plural.
Plural breaths. No. I'm not saying that. All I'm saying is it's too fancy. It's way too fancy. The death threat with the crayons and we're going to get you.
No one said crayons. I didn't have you seen it?
The FBI is fucking investigating this shit.
As they should. And when it comes out that it's some dumb shit, now what? It's like Bernie Sanders campaign members or something. Staff. I'm just saying it's gonna be something stupid.
It's definitely over the
You're
top.
You're telling me these MAGA white dudes watch Empire to know who this guy is to pick all the people. Oh, I forgot about the other check, Mark.
Is Jussie Smollett white famous?
He's not.
I think he is. Yes, he is.
I wouldn't know who the fuck he was if I hadn't watched one and a half seasons of Empire.
Are you asking your white side?
I watched one and a half seasons of Empire.
He is. He's in LA. He's in a lot of. He's a poster. I'm telling you.
He's not.
He's a poster boy for.
He's on Fox.
He's not a poster.
He's a poster boy for equality.
There are so many other black people that white people don't like.
No, I'm talking about. No, you're right. I don't think that he's one of those. But I'm saying he's definitely.
He's an advocate for the LGBT.
A really big advocate.
Can I give you one more check mark? They're like, you know what? We got to do this crazy thing to this guy. But how are we going to get everybody to know about it? Jasper, let's get a celebrity. check, another one. Like, it's all
that
the checks.
One, I'm not giving you much for that one. That one's kind of
weird. Why wouldn't they just pick a gay dude on the street and beat him?
No, I think they picked a gay guy, and they pick one that's not, that is likable across the board.
No, like, they pick one that's a celebrity likable. So that this makes
yeah,
news.
But there's a lot of white.
Where did you hear about
there's
it
first? There's a lot of celebrity.
Yeah, go ahead and say it.
There's a lot of celebrity gay guys. I think that he's one that's very liked. No one has anything bad
and
to say about him.
He's been an
ever.
Activist for LGBTQs. And, yeah.
And you think that these...
Hell, MLK was widely known, and he was an activist, clearly, and he got some of the same
you
treatment.
Think these white supremacists went that deep to find this guy? He's perfect. He's perfect. He is perfect. He's a celebrity. Tell me this, and just say it with pride. Where's the first place you heard? Who was reporting on this first?
First of all, that's irrelevant.
Who was reporting on this first? I'm going to look at Kevin while you answer the
I don't
business.
Need... it doesn't matter because all news comes from Instagram first, right?
No,
all news
that's
comes
not...
From
but
that.
Where the Instagram... Who's the news outlet that reported on it first?
I don't even know. I don't know.
It starts with a T.
I thought you were about to say TMZ.
Well, TMZ reports everything.
TMZ stalks outside of every celebrity's house.
TMZ reports everything.
You know how many people from TMZ are in Atlanta right now?
Like they do everything. They do have a person in Atlanta because Chili just met with them to share about the fact Weezer did a cover on No Scrubs. If anyone's interested in that, check out Weezer's
That was a
rendition.
Bad time to plug.
Yeah,
sorry.
What the fuck? Like, what is wrong with you?
You said TMZ.
We're talking about somebody getting their ass whooped and you're plugging your artist.
I'm so sorry.
The fuck?
TLC. She loves you, Chili.
Right. Good. Great.
She loves you.
Both of them. All of them.
Okay.
It had nothing to do with what we were talking
right.
about.
Right. I lost my train of thought. I had a good one, too.
Well,
I had
good.
A zinger.
I'm glad you did.
Didn't pick this guy. They didn't pick this guy. They could have gotten anybody. They picked this guy because he's the person who's going to make this a
he's
headline.
High profile.
It's going to make this a headline. They checked all of the boxes. It doesn't line up this perfectly for anyone.
Well, she said that they had been stalking this guy for weeks and sending him threatening messages and shit like he was...
And they just happened to be in Chicago when he was in Chicago.
Like he was even Malcolm X. They was, I'm going to see your red ass. They was even threatening phone calls,
Jussie.
Breathing in the shit. It's like, Faith!
You one dead
guys.
Red nigga.
Guys.
I'm just saying.
But you know what, though? I'm sorry. Ugh. I just, who would his Betty Shabazz be?
No. 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 Now, we actually had a call in to because of last week's show, right?
We did. Let me stop smiling, though, because this is serious. This
whole thing has been serious.
I'm sorry, Christal. That one is ridiculous.
But you know what?
Somebody got hurt.
I hate that. And I hate that. I'm glad that he's not hurt. He's hurt, but I'm glad he's not. I've had a fractured rib playing football. I mean, it's happened to me.
This is not about you.
But I'm saying I lived through it. His face does look really swollen on this side. It might be flipped because
Why
of the camera.
Why are you saying that?
I thought you would be more sensitive because he's beige. I thought you would be more
No,
empathetic.
No, no. Okay, see, if we were just talking about the fact that he got his ass whooped, I would have been part of this. Like, man, that is fucked up. Because he literally had to get his ass... That wasn't a game. That part of it wasn't a game. The rest of it is fucking ridiculous, though. And I can't take that seriously.
So what you're saying is that you are acknowledging that there was a crime done.
Absolutely.
But what you're saying is that you don't believe that it was these MAGA racist.
Nobody believes anything anymore. Anything that comes from the internet, no, you don't.
Are you kidding?
You don't believe anything.
Are you kidding? Y'all believe everything.
No.
Y'all believe everything
true.
That comes
and
from the internet.
First of all, what is this y'all? Like, who are you talking about?
You?
Kevin and I? Are
you? You and him
no,
and y'all.
Not.
All of you. I put you
that
all together.
That's not true.
Y'all
that
believe
that's true.
Y'all believe everything.
False.
Y'all believe everything. Everything?
You're trying
I'm a tough
to,
cookie. I believe nothing.
You're okay. You're just trying to create
it.
Propaganda and make it seem like we are the
like
masses.
Propaganda like MAGA. Should I yell MAGA as I shit on y'all?
Let's talk about the call that came in because of last week's show, which we talked about rape and the young lady Jasmine Eland in Atlanta that allegedly was raped. We don't know.
Mm-hmm.
What we do know is that the video looked really bad. And so we had a conversation about...
And what we do know is that this is a real thing. Whether or not it happened to her, this is a real thing. It
Absolutely.
Does happen to people.
I mean, it almost is like the same type of thing. Like when people that are on the other side of something come out and speak against it, it almost is like they're trying to... I think she was not the poster girl for this. However, it doesn't negate the fact that she absolutely... could have been raped. It's just the circumstances look bad
right.
when you're looking at the entire picture. But we had a call from a viewer, a listener rather.
So...
It's on Music Love Life. This is Britt Renee. After listening to last week's show, I really wanted to leave a voicemail because I could relate to some things that were talked about. Be honest, I talked about holding people accountable, your friends or just people in general, or checking them for their behaviors and actions. Crystal had mentioned the woman she saw in New Orleans a few years ago. I moved out of state. I didn't really know anybody, but I did have a friend. She's about 2 years younger than me. And she had a friend who's another year or two younger than her. Every other weekend, we would go out and, you know, have some drinks and just kind of unwind from the week. But her friend would get drunk every time. I mean, you'd have to pull her out of situations, you know, talk to her usually the next day and tell her what she did, or, you know, talk to her and tell her she shouldn't be doing stuff like that. I mean, anything from being in short dresses and doing splits on the dance floor, or dancing and letting her dress right up and not pulling it down. I mean, it got annoying. I'm not your mom. I'm tired of, you know, having to go back. Now, the first time, I thought maybe she just had a rough week. You know, she's just having too much fun. She's had too much to drink. But it was every single time. Then the last time I hung out with him, she was approached by two guys, and she was talking to him. She said something kind of racist, and I checked her. I said, that's it. I'm done. I can't hang out with you anymore because I'm tired of this babysitting gig. Like, it's ridiculous. I haven't seen her since. And another situation, I was in high school, senior year of high school. My parents were strict, and I was never able to really go to parties. I finally was able to go senior year, New Year's, and it was a friend's birthday. It was on. You know, we went to like 3 or 4 house parties, and I was, quote unquote, spending the night at my best friend's house, which was really going to be the case, but we weren't entirely sure. So Britt Renee had a little bit of everything to drink. I mean, I was mixing all kind of liquor that shouldn't have been mixed and having a bunch. Last stop finally caught up with me, and I had a whole bunch there. And I blacked out. I remember some parts of the night. I remember kind of being slumped over. I don't know who I was slumped over on. My best friend was coming out of the other room. I think she's coming out of the kitchen. But she came and she basically saved me. She then had a homegirl of ours sit next to me to make sure I was good while she finished doing what she was doing. And then I remember being carried to the car, partly, and then I blacked out again. I remember on the drive home, they opened the door so I would throw up outside. And then I remember her changing my clothes because I threw up on myself. And I remember crying and telling her I'm sorry, because I'm sorry that she is having to do all this. But that's it. I don't remember anything else. And from what I was told and what I remember is that some of our guy friends from high school were, you know, trying to sit next to me and putting their arm around me and whatever. But she basically saved me. I don't know what I would have done if she wasn't there, because I don't know that any of my other homegirls from high school would have stepped in or said anything to anybody, you know, but she took care of me. So I'm forever grateful. To this day, I don't drink like that. I've never been anywhere close to that. I didn't even touch alcohol for about 2 years after that night. But that is very real. The blacking out is very real. Not being able to talk or move, you know, but I was blacked out though. Like, I was done. So it's knowing your limit. And if you ever get to that point or you ever get drugged, I hope somebody is there who will help you and take care of you, because it's sad that if you were to get that intoxicated or if you get drugged, that there aren't people around you that have the decency to be human and put you in a safe situation. You should keep yourself in a safe situation, but if you ever get to that point. But yeah, it's very real. And that's all I wanted to share. Sorry this voicemail is so long, but telling all that, it took a minute. But anyway, love the show. I listen every week that one is dropped, and I really enjoy hearing you guys. Thanks.
And thank you. First of all, thank you for calling in. That was, I think it's great that people are able to hear real people, you know, that that have experienced things. I think it kind of lends to the discussion, because if it's us, the three of us talking, you hear our experiences, and then a lot of times people can discount that. And then also when we hear things that are going on in the media, we don't know all the particulars, so it's also easy to discount that. But when you hear real life stories from listeners, that's, it's powerful, because it, it speaks to everything that's going on. Now, I actually appreciate the fact that she brought up something that I hadn't thought about, because I've definitely been that person that was with a friend that was doing too much. And one girl, I was just like, I'm not doing that. I wasn't as close to her. I remember a girl in college, I won't say her name, but she asked me to come with her because she didn't want to, you know, she was like, she wanted to drink and she didn't want to get, she didn't want anything to happen. I was like, I'm not babysitting you, you know? But I didn't think about the fact that a person may learn from their experiences. And so I think we have to just be more empathetic as people. You know what I mean? Like, maybe she should have asked a closer friend at that time, because if it had been one of my close friends, I definitely would have done that. But I just, and she probably had friends that were close that were tired of babysitting in my case. But the idea that if you do look out for someone, they may be indebted and grateful to you.
And you prevent some really bad shit from happening. Potentially.
Yeah.
She said two things. One thing was, what you said, you know, learning from your mistakes. But also, she kind of reiterated what we were all saying last week, and that's, people have to be accountable.
Mm-hmm.
If you're there with your friend, say something to your friend. That's guys, girls, whoever.
Mm-hmm.
Say something. Grab somebody. Talk to somebody. Say something to someone. Don't just you know, pretend like, oh, they'll figure it out. You know,
right.
It's just innocent. It may not be innocent, and it's up to everyone to be accountable for everyone else.
Right. And I think that, you know, friends, I don't have friends that I can't be honest with. I don't have a large group of friends. I have a very small group of people that I'm really close to. But those people, I can tell them the truth. And I want them to tell me the truth. You know what I mean? I think the three of us have been honest with each other on numerous occasions. And sometimes the person may not want to hear the truth. But if you really care about somebody, you're going to do that. And that's all about, friendship should be about accountability. So you should be able to say to your friend, I was afraid for you. You know what I mean? This could have happened. You have to have real conversations with people. And I think a lot of times as women, yes, my mom was very good about, you know, saying, you know, a man is wrong if he does X, Y, and Z, but there has to be some self-accountability that you have, and reminding a woman that I protected you from this. However, you put yourself in the situation that I shouldn't have to do that.
Over and over again sometimes.
Yeah.
Like the first girl she talked about every week.
Yeah, and I think that's also because, you know, that something is going on with that person. You know what I mean? So it's, therapy or something else is needed, because that isn't, the need to get that type of attention, and to, if you're getting drunk and acting out on a regular basis, there's a bigger problem there, you know? But I just think that people saying something to your friend, as opposed to just looking at her, because I've been out and seen it, you know what I mean? Where someone's doing something and everybody just kind of looks, and then they turn away. Because as a, you know, a lot of times it's uncomfortable to get involved in something, because guys are like, oh, it's none of your business. Stop blocking. Stop hating. When it comes to one of my friends, I don't care about blocking and hating. I'll do all of the above, because I'm not going to let one of them get caught. But that is something that I think people get caught up in the not wanting to block or not wanting to be a hater. But if you save someone from being raped, that's not blocking or hating. That's just, you know, being a good friend.
But you know what? I think in society, no one wants to, especially in a party environment,
mm-hmm.
nobody necessarily wants to be the lame one.
Right.
If I saw a girl and she's obviously intoxicated and she's dancing, wilding out, her skirt's riding up, she's not pulling it down or whatever, I may think, oh, this person is putting on a show.
Right.
They're intentionally, especially if they don't pull their dress down, I'm thinking they're intentionally trying to display themselves.
Can you qualify that? Because you said intoxicated. So are you talking about intoxicated or inebriated to the point where they're not in control anymore?
Okay, maybe. Well, I just mean acting party wild, right?
Okay.
you know, dancing hard, probably. I mean, you've been to some parties, dancing hard, probably sweating. Your clothes move. Mm. Right.
I'm just saying, skirts having ride something up, to drink, et cetera. Having something to drink, you could be intoxicated. But I'm talking about where you're not
conscious of what you look like. You know what I mean? That's different. Mm-hmm. I think that there's a difference, like you said, between being tipsy and feeling good and being a little extra flirtatious and not being aware of what's happening around you.
What kind of dude wants that girl?
But see,
that happens way too often. As disgusting as that sounds, that happens way too often. Girls wake up. I remember in college, my sweet mates would say, and they were, you know, for sorority girls, they were Caucasian. And I remember, you know, coming, and one of the girls was like, oh my God, I passed out. I don't know who I slept with last night. And I was like, oh my God, we need to go beat someone up. Like, it's time to rally the troops. And they were like, it's not a big deal. You know what I mean? Because, oh my God, I got drunk and passed out. I hope I didn't sleep with anybody. Oh my God, I just remember who. And I'm like, girl, we got to go beat somebody's ass. Like, it's time to go. Let me call the Qs. But they were, it was a different.
It's probably the Qs.
No, they weren't. Trust me, the Qs weren't invited to the white sorority parties at OU. It was very racist while I was there. It was a MAGA situation.
Very segregated.
It was very segregated. I mean, they would have blackface parties, but that's a whole nother story.
Never mind.
No, go ahead.
No, there's a friend of mine that had a story about Qs, but I mean, I'll just leave.
Yeah, well, I have a story myself, but the point is, I think that we just have to redefine accountability, you know, in all of this. I think that definitely we need to make sure that we're serious about rape, but then we also have to address the other side of the coin. And that is, if you see a girl that you know that you're friends with and you would feel guilty if you heard she got raped, then you need to speak up if you see something happening.
But you know what? If like, for example, this is Super Bowl week, mm-hmm. right? And they've already said, you know, sex trafficking is going to be higher, et cetera, whatever. But people in these parties that are going on, most times, just from my experience, unless you're fighting or something like that, that could, you know, break something or be a disturbance to the party, the club owners or the security, they're going, a girl just dancing while they're going to let that ride.
Yeah.
They're not going to step in and say, hey, are you okay?
It's different with a girl dancing. I mean, you can definitely tell the difference when someone is out of it. Like, I will never get the picture of that young woman out of my head that I saw being raped. Because she would wake up and not know what happened. And you could tell she was totally out of it. It's totally different than somebody, and I've also been around a lot of drunk girls. Now, I don't know if they're blacked out or not, but they're standing up, they're grabbing at people, they're doing all kinds of stuff. So I think there's a difference between being drunk and being, you know, at the point where you're no longer in control and you can be taken advantage of.
And see, I don't doubt that alcohol, it's like alcohol itself, if you mm-hmm. consume beyond a certain point, you can definitely black out.
Yeah.
Right? If someone sprinkles something in your drink, then that just takes it to another level.
Yeah, absolutely.
But you can get drunk you can black out just on the alcohol itself.
Yeah.
But I don't know what that's. I'm not a big drunk. Like, I'm never, I'm not a big drinker.
I don't know what that
would
feel like either.
I'm more of a smoker than a drinker, personally.
Oh,
I'm just saying.
How are we not surprised that it's you? How are we not surprised?
I've blacked out 3 times.
Jesus help us.
One time in France.
Well, that's safe.
You told me that story.
That's safe.
Another time was in Alabama A&M. I was cross-faded, though.
Not France to Alabama. What a big jump.
And I didn't, you know what's fucking crazy?
You been
crazy?
To Alabama A&M?
The Hill,
no,
right?
Thankfully,
it's
no.
It's a fun place.
I blame this chick, though, because her dumb ass said, your friend is about to fall. And I fell, right, when she said that. And they took pictures.
Are those pictures available?
I don't know. It's a long time.
Somewhere. Someone has them.
I think I may have been in high school still.
Well, I hope that people will continue to talk about this subject because it's very serious. And I think that we can kind of start, even if it's just one person.
I don't want people to talk about it. I want people to say something.
That's what I'm saying. I think they have to have the conversation.
But you know what celebrities talk about all the time? They say drink responsibly.
What? That has nothing to do with this. What?
Yeah, it does.
Drink responsibly.
That does.
I'm talking about once the drink is in your system, help a person, stop a rape.
Right. Not even a rape. There's so many things that could happen. I mean, drunk driving, injuring themselves.
But see, I think that's a perfect example. With drunk driving, I think people are a lot more aware. I've been places, I was at my high school reunion and we took somebody's keys and we're like, no, we're not giving them back.
Right.
We're not doing that.
You don't have a choice.
I think people are very, you know, one of my friends used to drive for this service before Uber was as popular as it is. But even still, it's a service that will pick you up and take you home. Like, and all you have to do is pay a tip, safe ride. Like, yeah, just, you know.
I literally heard about a service that would, if you told them where you are, they will send a car, will come and bring someone to get you, and someone else would drive your car.
Oh, wow.
So you would ride in the car with the person who you called or whatever. It's like Uber or Lyft on steroids. Right.
Yeah, that's cool.
Like, they would send somebody to drive your car home as well.
But that's what Safe Ride did. They got your car home safe. It was two people. It was. Mm-hmm. So it might have been them. But yeah, I just hope that people keep talking about this. And, you know, things, at least little changes, grassroots change are the best ones to me. And I do think drunk driving has the numbers have gotten less and less because people are aware of that. And when someone's leaving the club, they will say, whoa, dude.
I'll be honest with you. Because I was driving Lyft for a while on the side, and every weekend that I would drive at night, I would literally see, like, on cue, almost, I would see people crashing their cars, drunk driving.
But I think it's still
into other people, into a tree, into a wall, on the road, whatever.
I've seen somebody hit the side rail, head full speed, just, you could tell weaving. But I still think it's less, you know, because the deaths we hear are less. So, I mean, everything helps.
I hope so. But, hey, one is enough.
It is. We hope you guys are paying attention. If you have questions or comments, please leave them on our page or on the YouTube channel. Hopefully we can change some, you know, make some small change. Make some small change.
You mean like some money?
No, changes in changing.
I thought you said people can donate. Like, you know, donate, ask a question, but donate to get an answer. This is capitalism.
Crystal's donating her birthday to drunk driving charities.
She should donate her vagina.
Oh my God.
Hey,
like, share.
Hey, no,
subscribe.
Hold on. Look. Hey, for real, honestly, the first time, you get the first one.
Like, share.
If you share, let's say, what's the number?
Like.
Most. If you are the person who shares the most.
Hey, that was a hairpin turn, boy.
Like, share, subscribe.
Nut. That's a like, share, surprise. So what is it? Nut.
Get off. Music, love, life.